Let me show you how you can create a Power BI top end report, but with a variable end. That means you can choose to show either your top 10 customers or top 50 or top 100 or really any top or bottom number that you like. This is part of our top end playlist where we would be covering lots of different topics around the top end theme. You would be able to access the playlist at the end of this video. Now, if you would like to become a Power BI Pro, make sure to subscribe and click that bell icon so you're notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. In the first video in this series, we had seen how we can filter down to our top 10 customers, and we had also seen how we can do an analysis on the revenue that the top 10 customers are bringing in. And this was pretty cool. So once we have this measure defined, we can slice and dice it any which way we want, by country, by product, so to see how top heavy they are. For example, we could say, hey, what has been the trend of the top 10 customers' revenue for France? Again, you can watch that first video as part of the top end playlist. But now our goal is to do the same analysis, but we want to be able to vary, to choose. Sometimes we may want to see the top 10 customers. Maybe for other markets, we would want to see top 50 or top 100 or any other number like that. So let's see how we can get to do that. So here I have the top 10 analysis, but right now it's hard-coded to only be for the top 10 customers. So what I'm going to do is just duplicate this page and get started on the variable end. Now, the first thing that I need to do is that provide Power BI so that somehow I can send it that signal that I want to see the top 10 or top 50 or top 100 or something else. Now, Power BI cannot read my mind. In fact, pretty much the only way Power BI gets its data from are my tables. Hence, I'm going to create a table. In fact, if you look at your report, besides maybe text boxes, images, and shapes, every single thing that is being shown here comes from a table. So that's our first task. We're going to create a table which can send that signal to Power BI to say top 5, 10, 50. Now, the easiest way to do that is just hit this enter data button right here, and that's what I'm going to do. So click enter data, and this brings up a dialog box here, and let's say select N, and we're going to fill in our options. For now, I'm going to say 5, 10, 20, 50, and 100, and we'll stay with that, and we'll call the table select top N. And I'm going to hit load, and this is going to be loaded into my model. Now, this is going to be a table, and what we're going to do next is define some measures to see which N has been selected. So now this table is loaded up here. Now I can put this on there and make it a slicer. Let's change this to a list slicer. So we have 5, 10, 20, 50, and 100. But right now it doesn't have any effect on that. Now we want to obviously change that so that this impacts, this drives this report. So the first step for that would be to create a measure which tells me which N has been selected. So I'm going to go to modeling and click new measure right there. Now this is, for those who are familiar, this approach is called disconnected slicer, because we're not going to establish a relationship between this table with the other table, but still in a way it's acting like a relationship, almost like a dotted line, because it's filtering the same way relationships do. All right, so we'll say selected N. And let's see what we can do here. Selected N equals, and I'm just going to use one of the built-in functions, selected value. Select value, did that work? Selected value, top, select N. That's the one that I'm looking for. Perfect. I'm going to hit enter, zoom out. And now let's see if we can make some space so we can see that measure. So as we have selected N, I'm going to bring it up here. Dragged it over there. Change it to a card. So there we go. It's working. And of course, if nothing is selected here, it's going to be blank. And I can build some default behavior if I want to, like default to 10 or something like that. But for now, I'm going to leave it as this. So right now, it's affecting this, but it's only affecting this. What I would like to do is to have that selection affect the entirety of this report. So that's what we're going to work on next. Now, we had already built the top 10 measures, and they are already there in the model. Now, if you realize that the way the top 10 is written, the only part that we actually need to change is this one. And instead of hard coding it as 10, all we need to do is simply use the selected n value. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to copy this measure over here and put this in this new table that I just created. And I'm going to say new measure. And all I'm going to change is I'm going to make it generic, top n, not top 10. And the n is going to be fed by that table. So you see, all I did was, well, change the label here so that, because it's not top 10 anymore. And instead of 10, I say, well, use whatever value has been selected in there. So it's as easy as that. So that's my first measure. I'm also going to grab the percentage sales and change that to a generic measure. So I'm going to say percentage sales for top n, and a measure is all about reuse. So once I've defined the top n, all I can do is just change that to use it here, right? So I changed top 10 to top n, just the name, and here I'm going to use the new measure, and that's it. I'm going to hide this column. I don't really need this. This table is just holding my measures. All right, so what I'm going to do is right now, of course, it's still not doing anything because I'm still using the old measures. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to snap my finger and I'm going to change all my measures to not use the sales top 10, top 10, but use the more generic top N measures, right? So I'm going to swap, remove these ones and use these ones. And it's going to happen in 3, 2, 1. All right, so all those measures have been changed. So all I did was just to remove the top 10 measures and drag this new ones in. Now, of course, right now you don't notice any difference because the sales N is actually selected at top 10. But now the complete report is being driven by that. I'm going to delete this. We don't really need that anymore. That was just for debugging. And now we can say, hey, show me how much revenue has been coming in from my top 10 customers. Ooh, what about top 5? Ooh, what about top 20? Now, one thing I noticed right away is that this was hard-coded. This was a text box. So let's go and change that. So what we're going to do is instead of this, we're going to create a text measure. So we're going to go back to the selected N. And I'm just going to say new measure. And we'll say selected N label. And we'll say top. So we want to show that. And then ampersand. And we'll bring in the selected value. And we'll say, if I can type, analysis, perfect. And now we can bring that in, change that to a card. All right, great. So I changed the formatting a little bit, but now that label is dynamic as well. So we can be looking at top 10 and see the percentage of revenue has dropped through the year. Earlier, we were getting 3.4, you know, between 3 and 4%. And then at the end of the year, it was down to around 1.5%. If you look at the top 5 customers, this shows the trend for that. This is the top 20, top 50, top 100. And you can see what's going on here. Hey, so just for fun, this is AdventureWorks. It's kind of hard to find, nuggets of wisdom or insight in here. But we're going to expand it to more, maybe 1,000, 10,000 customers and just see what it looks like. All right, so just hit edit queries and this popped up our query editor. And in here, I'm going to go back to the top end query, go back to the source that I'd entered, and I can now say something like 500,000, let's say 10,000. Let's stop there. Hit OK, hit close and apply. And now I expect this table to expand and we can see some of the other analysis. So how have we been doing if you look at our top 500 customers? Boy, so this is really interesting. You see this big dip in June, but generally there's a downward trend. So generally our top 500 customers, the percentage of revenue they contributed went all the way from nearly 100% to down to 60%. So clearly we expanded our customer base. 10,000 is probably going to be a flat line because that's nearly all of our customers. But this is interesting. So again, you can see that something happened in June. And if you have been following AdventureWorks closely, my friend, have been paying attention to the stock market news, years, then June was a big month for them and there was a lot of activity there. So there's clearly some correlation here. So I'm just messing around, having fun with AdventureWorks, as much fun as is possible with AdventureWorks. Now, of course, real data is where the real fun happens. So apply this to your real data set and see what kind of insights you can find. The top end analysis is one of my favorite analysis to understand how a business is doing and how top heavy is it, how has that changed over time, and where is that right line between serving your top customers but also expanding your customer base. As promised, you can access the complete top end playlist on the screen by clicking on the cards or in the description below. Now, more videos will be added to it, so make sure you stay subscribed. Until next time, power on, my friend.
Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.